Hello and welcome to a film produced by Team Conjet. The intention with this film is to show you how to set the parameters for a cut. So let's get to it. We got two screens that we can work on. One that is situated on the robot and one on the remote control panel or the remote control box. So this film will show you how to set these parameters that operates the robot, and they are five. There are five parameters. Passes, that determines how many times the cutting head will move from side to side before doing the step, that is the second parameter. We're also going to talk about the period that dictates the oscillation RPM of the jet. The lance angle is the fourth parameter, and the last parameter in this little session is the speed. And before I start to adjust my parameters, I have to decide which mode I want to work in, if it is the standard mode or the advanced mode. The difference is how many parameters can I set. The standard have five and the advanced have a few more. There's also a selection of languages. So I can select a language on my robot, and I can select another language on my remote control. So they do not have to be the same. I can have one on each. Let's not be so bold. Once I've selected my language, I select the operational mode. And the mode I select is standard. Now, let me first describe a little bit of what happens on these screens. On the left-hand side, I have settings. It is the same on all these parameter pages. My left-hand side shows the settings, and when I push the button for settings, I open it up and I can adjust the settings. On the right-hand side, I have options. And if there are any options on this particular page, first of all, the button will be illuminated and there will be an icon to show you what it is. To change the option, I have to push and hold for 2.5 seconds. And this delay is intentional so that we don't accidentally change a parameter or an option. So now we are on the number of passes page. I have the options that I can change, or the fields, the objects that I can change, and I go in between them by rotating the selector knob. So I move in between these two fields by rotating the selector knob, and if I want to change it, or when I want to change, I push, I change, I observe the change that is happening on the screen, and when I have my selection, I push again. To do the setting on my remote control, I have to first of all wait for the little green light to come on, or the green square to come on. If I change to another page, it will start yellow and eventually go green. When it is green, then I can change my parameters. So let's go back to the passes page. Let me switch that to the correct language. So when I have my green light, I change by pushing the acknowledge button on the right hand side. I increase and decrease with a plus and minus. And when I am done, when I've done my setting, I push the acknowledge button again. And now I am back to the same screen as we started with. And on the remote control, I also have my settings. And I also have my options. Note that when I push the button for the option, these LED change color. And now I have changed my option. So that's the passes. Let's move into the next screen. And this screen determines my step length. So this is how far the robot will move when it moves after the amount of passes have been completed. And I set it in the form of an overlap. When the jet moves over the surface, it moves by oscillating the lands from side to side, and it oscillates at a width. And that width is the oscillation width. And I say here, how much overlap do I want in that width? So by adjusting my overlap, I tell how much will I cut again from one pass to the next. So in this particular case, I have a 20% overlap. I will step 81 millimeter, and the overlap will be 20%. And this is automatically calculated by the robot, the 20% overlap. Moving into the oscillation, where I set my oscillation and RPM, I set it as a period. So as the jet moves over the surface, it creates a snake pattern, and I determine how much distance do I want from one top to the next. So by adjusting the period, you see how that stretches? By adjusting the period, I determine how fast my lands will oscillate. So 25 millimeter is a standard setting for the RPM, or for the period. And it says that period is normally set to 10 times the size of the nozzle. So if I have a larger nozzle, I may start with a larger period. If I have a smaller, I may set a smaller. But this is basically a rule of thumb. The next parameter are my angles. I can set an angle when the head is moving towards left. You remember, I push the button to activate the function. I turn it to increase or decrease, and I also see on the screen what happens when I rotate the encoder. So 22 on one side, and I move over to the right side, and I decrease that if I want. So that shows that I can have one angle going left, one angle going right. So that's the angles. My last parameter is the speed. And this speed controls four functions. It controls the speed of the cutting head, it controls the speed of lands turning, and it controls the oscillation RPM based on the period. It also controls the speed of step and the speed in which the complete robot is moving over the surface when it makes the step. When I am done with all my settings, I push the check mark, and that only shows me that I'm ready to start. Push the S5 on the remote control, and we are cutting. Should you feel any doubts, use the guide to refresh your memory. The guide is a short, compact version of the training that you receive when the robot is delivered. Move back and forth using the arrow keys, and it will take you through the startup procedure, the safety precautions, maneuvering the robot, and the setting of parameters. You can exit the guide at any time.